today we're going to be discussing healthcare agencies. Healthcare agencies are any public or private organization that delivers skilled nursing and other therapeutic services to patients. The person is always the focus of care. Staff members have special talents, knowledge, and skills. All staff members work together to meet the needs of the patient. Healthcare agencies have four purposes. First is health promotion, which is teaching people about healthy living in order to prevent disease from happening. For instance, teaching individuals about the food pyramid so they can make healthy food choices. Next, we have disease prevention, which includes vaccines and smoking cessation programs. Third, we have the detection and treatment of disease, which includes diagnostics like lab work and radiology scans. Finally, healthcare agencies serve to provide rehabilitation and restorative care, which includes physical, occupational, and speech therapy following an illness or injury. Many healthcare agencies are learning sites for students. Students participate in providing care. There are multiple types of healthcare agencies. First, we have hospitals, which is where an individual would go for care and treatment of an acute illness or injury. Next, we have assisted living facilities, which are housing options for older individuals who need help with ADLs, yet wish to remain independent for as long as possible. Little or no medical care is provided. A home-like setting is provided. Assisted living residents typically need help with personal care, meals, medications, personal safety, and/or transportation. Assisted living residents must be mobile and have stable health. Next, we have rehabilitation centers, which provide physical, occupational, and speech therapy for individuals who have suffered an illness or injury. Next is mental health centers, which provide treatment for patients with mental health disorders, such as depression, anxiety, bipolar disorder, and schizophrenia. Hospice is a type of agency that provides care for the terminally ill, meaning the individual was deemed to have less than 6 months left to live. Long-term care centers are also known as nursing homes and nursing facilities. They provide assistance with ADLs, medication management, and they also sometimes have memory care units for people with Alzheimer's or dementia. Finally, there are home health agencies, which provide care in the patient's home. Let's practice. Number one, Mr. S is a 65-year-old male, status post right TKA. What type of facility would be appropriate for this patient? Mr. Smith just had a recent surgery and is in need of physical and occupational therapy prior to going home. As such, a rehab center would be the best facility for him. Number two, Elizabeth is an 8-year-old female with complaints of acute right lower quadrant pain. What type of facility would be appropriate for this patient? Elizabeth has an acute need, the right lower quadrant pain, which most likely represents appendicitis. As such, she should go to the hospital for treatment. Number three, Ruth is an 89-year-old female with COPD. She needs assistance with some ADLs, but is mostly independent. What type of facility would be appropriate for this patient? Ruth should go to an assisted living facility where she can receive some help with her ADLs, but remain independent for as long as possible. Number four, Mrs. L is a 55-year-old patient with terminal cancer. What type of facility would be most appropriate for this patient? Terminal means unlikely to have a cure. As such, hospice would be the best type of facility or agency for Mrs. L. Okay, number one, Clifford is a 45-year-old male with a history of bipolar disorder. He is in a manic crisis. What type of facility would be most appropriate for this patient? Bipolar disorder is a mental health disorder, and Clifford should seek treatment at a mental health facility. Number two, Caroline is a 76-year-old female with dementia. She is an elopement risk and requires assistance with all ADLs. What type of facility would be most appropriate for this patient? Caroline should go to a long-term care or a nursing center where the staff can provide her the assistance she needs with her ADLs. Finally, Mr. C is a 33-year-old male, status post MVC, or motor vehicle collision. He is ready to be discharged from the hospital but requires wound care. What type of facility or agency is most appropriate for this patient? Mr. C no longer needs the acute care that a hospital provides, but he still needs some assistance. Home health would be the most appropriate placement for him. Organization of healthcare agencies. Agencies have a governing body called the Board of Trustees or Board of Directors. The board makes agency policies. Underneath the Board of Directors, there are administrators who manage the agency. Underneath the administrators, you have the directors or department heads who manage specific areas of the agency. And finally, you have the interdisciplinary care team who are involved in caring for the patient. The interdisciplinary care team consists of all the health professionals whose skill and knowledge focus on the person's care. This can include registered nurses, CNAs, doctors, and therapists. Organization of nursing services. At the top, you have the director of nursing. That is the registered nurse who is responsible for the entire nursing staff. Under the director of nursing, you have nurse managers who assist the director of nursing. Nursing areas usually have charge nurses for each shift. Charge nurses are responsible for the nursing staff on their shift. So staff RNs report to the charge nurse. LPNs report to staff or RNs or the charge nurse. And CNAs report to the nurse supervising their work. Nursing also has nurse educators that are part of nursing services. Nurse educators provide education to new staff and provide continuing education as new products and procedures roll out. There are several nursing care patterns. The pattern used depends on how many persons need care, the staff, and the cost. First is functional nursing, which focuses on tasks and jobs. With functional nursing, every care person has a task. For instance, one CNA may be in charge of all the vital signs, while another CNA takes the patients their meals, while a registered nurse brings all the patients their medications. Next is team nursing. That's when different disciplines involved with taking care of the patient come together and are led by an RN. Care is decided based on abilities and licenses. Primary nursing involves total care. That is when one nurse is in charge of a specific patient's care, all of it. They give the medications, do the vital signs, bring the food, anything that that patient needs, the nurse takes care of. Patient-focused care occurs when the care and services are moved from departments to the patient's bedside. So the patient is not inundated with multiple people having them go different places throughout the day. For example, a phlebotomist usually draws blood, but in patient-focused care, the nurse would draw the blood and then send it to the lab. That way, the patient has the same nursing team working with them and not a variety of individuals. There's also something called case management, and that's when an RN coordinates a patient's care. Case management sees care from beginning to end, even when the patient gets home. The case manager makes sure that all follow-up appointments are set up and that the patient has the equipment they need to get home safely. Paying for healthcare. You can have something called private insurance, which is bought by individuals and families. You can also have group insurance, which is bought by groups or organizations for individuals. So for instance, Loudoun County Public School purchases group insurance that their employees can take part in. Private and group insurance can be something known as managed care. Managed care deals with health delivery and payment. Managed care limits the choice of where to go for healthcare and the care that doctors can provide. Many insurers must approve the need for healthcare. If the service is approved, the insurance will pay for the service. If the service is not approved, the patient pays. Another term for managed care would be an HMO. Next, we have Medicare, which is a federal health insurance program for individuals over 65 years of age. Some younger people with certain disabilities are covered, and people with end-stage renal disease on dialysis are also covered. Part A covers hospitals, nursing centers, hospice, home, and home care costs. Part B covers doctor visits, ambulance services, medical equipment, mental health, and a limited amount of medications. Finally, there's Medicaid, which is a healthcare program sponsored by the federal government and operated in the states. It's typically only available to lower income individuals. Agency standards. Standards are set by the federal and state governments and accrediting agencies. An agency must meet standards for licensure, certification, and accreditation. If standards are met, the agency will receive a license, certification, or accreditation. If deficiencies are found, the agency is given time to correct them. Agencies can be fined for uncorrected or serious deficiencies. Surveys are done to see if an agency meets standards. The CNA's role in the survey process is to remain professional and answer all questions accurately and honestly.